Welcome back, it's Nod, and today we have another big video for you guys. We are going to be talking about Elden Ring concept art. We're talking about a new Naughty Dog project for the PS5, some new updates on the CES 2021 trailer where it was stating a bunch of third-party release dates that has now been corrected, and lastly, we're going to be talking about how well sales did for the PS5 and PS4 in December 2020. Now, before we get into that, if you haven't subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. Now let's get right into this, and it's coming straight from PSU.com, titled New Elden Ring Concept Art for the Reveal Trailer Emerges. New Elden Ring concept art has emerged online, showcasing the reveal trailer for the game in its early days when it was being conceptualized. So this new concept art comes from Gabriel Bjork Stjernstrøms, I think that's how you pronounce his name, over on his ArtStation profile, and we get to see a lot. We get a look at the man who appeared to be forging something in the trailer and the item being forged. We also get to see what this table looked like over time and how the trailer changed from conceptualization to reality. With different designs for both the table and the surrounding area, we can also see how the design changed to avoid similarities between Elden Ring and Dark Souls. You can see a few pieces of the concept art, which I'll have on screen for you, and I'll also have the link in the description. And it's quite detailed still, even though it is concept art. Looks really good. I'm excited, very excited for this game, but we continue to wait and continue to wait just to see something. But right now, all we really have is this concept art to go off of outside of the reveal trailer that we got. Boy, I'm really hoping that this is the year that we're finally going to get a release date, or at least some sort of information, like a trailer or something. But as far as that goes, this is the update for Elden Ring. As little as it may be, it is something rather than nothing. So on to our next topic, and this comes from PSU.com as well. Now, this is originally from Neil Druckmann's tweet, where he talks about a new posting for jobs over at Naughty Dog. So essentially, Naughty Dog's Neil Druckmann has taken to Twitter to advertise a number of job openings at the California-based studio, and this is the first time that he has publicly commented on the project. We all know that there is a project in the works, likely a PS5 project, and Neil Druckmann says, come work with us. We're making something very cool, and he retweets the Naughty Dog Jobs Twitter handle. Basically, it says, seeking a new role in 2021, Naughty Dog is hiring. We're looking for talented game devs across multiple disciplines. Visit naughtydog.com/careers to apply. Guys, there's a lot of jobs open, like a ridiculous number of jobs open, so they must be working on something pretty massive, and it seems like this isn't just going to be a small entry. I mean, we kind of expected, or we thought that there would be a middle entry to kind of fill the void before the next big one, but based on how many jobs are open here, I imagine maybe we're looking at something a little more ambitious than that, but only time will tell, as obviously there's so much limited information based on this job opening, but really excited to see what comes out of Naughty Dog. I think they have a lot of good stuff going for them. You know, after The Last of Us 2, obviously a game that was controversial, the game was technically very impressive, whether you like the story or not, and I think at least in that aspect, everybody can agree that, you know, on a technical level, we don't really see games with that kind of polish, and we don't really see games that are that well done. So I'm really excited to see what they're going to be working on. Obviously, as I say, we can't really extract any more information from this, like what kind of game will it be? Is it The Last of Us 3? Is it going to be Uncharted? Is it going to be a new IP? It's hard to say, but I'm sure in due time, we will get some information, maybe end of the year, or maybe early 2022. We'll see what happens. But on to our next topic, and this is all about Sony's CES 2021 presentation. So this article is titled, Sony Removes PS5 Release Windows for Third-Party Games from CES Presentation. So if you guys remember, at CES 2021, we got a trailer, and at the end of the trailer, it showed off a bunch of third-party release dates, including Project Athia, Pragmata, and Kena: Bridge of Spirits, and Stray. So these are big titles, especially Project Athia, where we had no idea when the release date was going to be, but they were showing off some, like, almost solid timelines here, and Pragmata had a delay of 1 year, but basically, Sony has removed that since. They've only removed the third-party titles. They've pretty much kept all the first-party stuff, which we already knew anyway, so it wasn't really a reveal. But yeah, I talked about this earlier when we first revealed it, and when I first made that video, was that they might just correct this or remove it. It probably won't stay in, and that really did end up being the case here. Do I think that there's no validity to these dates? I think that internally they probably believe these to be the actual release dates, but they just haven't revealed it yet, and they're also not solid release dates. Like, they could move, but I don't think where those are 100% the dates we are going to expect. So it's definitely a case where I wouldn't really take those dates at face value, because we don't know. They were probably internal dates, and they're not solidified in the sense that the companies think that they're going to actually have them out those days, and that's why they haven't revealed it to us publicly. So unfortunately, this is something that happens with trailers, and you know, Sony makes mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes, right? So it's not a surprise that this kind of thing can happen. But yeah, originally when I first saw this, I said, if it's not real, they're going to get rid of it. Or if they weren't supposed to say something, they're going to get rid of it down the line. But overall, you know what? It's fine. I think a lot of these games are probably going to come out in those timelines. In my opinion, obviously, we don't know for sure. But if I was a betting man, I would say that those timelines are probably realistic. Do I think Project Athia is going to come out in 2022? Probably. I mean, early 2022? I don't think so, but probably 2022. Kena Bridge of Spirits, that's definitely, I think that'll come out this year in March. I doubt it, but I do think it'll definitely be coming out this year. Now on to our last topic, and this also comes from PSU.com, and this is titled PS5 and PS4 sold extremely well in 2020 in the US, becoming some of the best-selling consoles of the year. So US NPD for December 2020 has now been released. PS5 finished 2020 as the second best-selling console of the year in dollar sales, while PS4 took the second spot for units sold. PS5 also set a new record with the most dollar sales for PlayStation hardware in that hardware's first December of release. So lots of records being set here for PlayStation, and they did a good job. I mean, PlayStation is really on the uprise, and they have been for a while now, but with the PS5 success, I don't imagine this is going to be stopping anytime soon. This original tweet does come from Matt Piscatella, and we've talked about him before. He does reveal a lot of different sales information naturally. So this is exciting for us if you're a PlayStation fan to see the success of a console that you've invested in. I imagine this is going to continue through 2021, even 2022. I don't imagine this is going to stop anytime soon, as the console had its biggest launch ever in consoles. And so that's not saying something small. That's a pretty big deal. And we're going to keep seeing that momentum grow over time, especially through, like I said, 2021, where we have all these third-party, first-party exclusives happening. And then in 2022, also having some pretty big exclusives happening between Final Fantasy 16, probably within that time frame. Project Athia, maybe within that time frame. We are looking at a lot of different titles that the PlayStation 5 is going to have, and we don't even know all the titles for 2022, so I'm just going based on speculation, really. So it's going to be an incredible year for PlayStation in 2021, and I can't wait to see what happens in 2022 as well. But that's all I have for you guys today. I am going to pass this on to you guys. Curious what you think of the new Elden Ring concept art. What do you think of Naughty Dog's new hiring spree they're going on? What do you think they could possibly be working on? How do you feel about Sony removing PS5 release windows for third-party games from that CES presentation? And lastly, what do you think of the success of PS4 and PS5 in December 2020 and just in 2020 in general? Let me know in the comments. And as always, if you haven't subscribed already, please hit that subscribe button. Hit that notification bell to get notified about all my upcoming videos, and hit the like button. It helps the channel a ton. You can follow me on Twitter and Twitch. Links will be in the description, and share this video with a friend. I will talk to you all on the next one. Take care.